So you may have heard of three terms that describe space rocks in astronomy. We have meteoroids, meteors, and meteorites. And I know they all sound very similar. They can be confused quite easily. They all have the root word meteor, which has Greek origins meaning high up or above the ground. So a meteoroid is a space rock still flying within our solar system. They can be broken off from an asteroid or some very large piece of space rock or even a comet. Then you have a meteor, when one of those meteoroids has entered Earth's atmosphere and is burning up as it streaks across the sky. Sometimes we call those shooting stars. And then if one of those meteors stays intact when it hits the ground, then we call that a meteorite. And if you actually find a meteorite that you saw in the sky, that's called a meteorite fall. And if you just find a meteorite on the ground randomly without seeing it streak across the sky, that's just simply called a meteorite find. So a couple of different categories for collectors there. So let's take a look at some of the meteorites that we have in our own collection. All right, so when it comes to meteorites, there are a few different types to consider. Most meteorites that are found are of the stony variety. They're made of silicate material, olivine, pyroxene, and they account for about 94 to 95% of all meteorite finds. Only about 5% are of the iron nickel variety, which is pretty surprising. Usually you'd think those mostly metal meteorites would be the majority of them. That's just not the case. And then only 1% of meteorite finds are of the stony iron. So we're talking half stone, half iron type. And those are pretty rare. All meteorites have some amount of metal in them. It just depends on how much they have. So in our MOAS collection, we have the iron nickel variety, which again, only account for about 5% of the ones found around the world. And here is one of them right here. This is really hefty. It's about 2 pounds, and that's quite amazing for, you know, how small this rock is. This is a 2 pound rock, so it's quite hefty the first time you hold it. And at some point in its history, it was a bit bigger than this, and it was flying through the atmosphere at tremendous speed. We're talking 80,000 miles per hour plus. When it was doing so, it was encountering a lot of atmospheric pressure as it was moving quickly through the atmosphere, and the friction was really building up, so it heats the surface around the meteorite. It creates what's called the fusion crust, and it will sometimes develop these thumb-like indentations. If you look carefully here, it almost looks like this is a big chunk of clay, and then I took my thumb and just kind of pushed inside. Those are called regmaglimps, and those are caused by the heating process as the meteor is streaking through the air. And that's what you see very clearly on our example from the museum. Now, this iron nickel type is really iron alloy or iron nickel alloy. So you have some minerals called Tennite and Camisite that you find inside of these. And these were the cores of asteroids. Just like the core of Earth is made of iron and nickel because dense, heavy things like to sink to the middle of planets or moons or even asteroids, same thing with these. These came from the central region of these big chunks of rock in space. And since they're made of metal, a magnet will stick to them, a little ball magnet here, so that kind of confirms the metal composition of it. And if you had a chance to cut one open, this is really interesting with iron nickel type meteorites. Well, if you cut them open, you would get this really interesting pattern that you can see here. You can see kind of a little bit of the light kind of shimmering across, so you can see the pattern really well. That pattern is called a Winman-Staaten pattern, or a Winman-Staaten pattern. It's a German name from a German scientist who sort of helped to discover this. And notice the kind of overlaying kind of lattice-like structure. That's the iron nickel alloys sort of layering on top of each other. And that's from the very slow cooling process of the metal. We're talking cooling over millions of years, and that creates this very distinct shape you find in iron nickel meteorites around the world. So these Rocks can tell you a lot about the solar system. They're the oldest things you can touch. They can be billions of years old and really give you a glimpse of what our solar system, planets and moons and asteroids are made of.